Gloria in excelsis Deo.
Et terra pax hominibus bonae voluntatis laudamus te benedicimus te agimus illi propter magnam gloriam tuam Domine Deus Deus adexit Deus pater omnipotens Domine
Rasis Virginis Deo et Patris.
nomino Spohobis Cu.
Et Cu Spiritu Tuo.
Sequentia Sancti Evangelii Secondo Luca. Compactum esses Jesus anorum dua decium, ascendendibus celestius mus secundum consulitinum diem festi, consummatus quae diebus, quam redemerit remissipue Jesus in Jerusalem, et non cognovem parentes eos, extimantes autem illim esse commutatu, venerit inter diei, et requiebant eum inter cognatus et notos, et non invenientes, regressi sunt in Jerusalem, requientes eam, et factum est postridum in venerant illim in templo, sedentem in medie doctorum, adienta illos in irrigantem eos, stupebanatum omnes, qui eam adiebant superpotentia et responses eos, evidentes admirati sunt, et dixit mater eos ad illum, fili quid facisti ignobis ihi, et cipatus tu et ego dolentes curabamus te, et ad illos, quid me quod me curabati is, neste patus quia in his, quae patris me sunt, abortet me esse, et ipse non intellects erant verbum, quod lucudus ad eos, et descendent cum es, et venet Nazareth, et eras subditus illis, et mater eras conservabit omnia verba haec in cordo suo, et Iesus proficebant sapiente et aetate, et gratia pro Deum, et homines.
How to live as a family and model our lives on the Holy Family. And throughout Catholic history, there have been many great families, mothers and fathers exempting in the Catholic faith. For example, the 19th of June, there's a particular Roman family who can celebrate their feast day, and they were all martyrs for the faith. Martha being one of the names, mother. But one example of a great family was St. Margaret of Scotland's family. And we pray for the people in Scotland today, as I've heard. The minister there has closed all churches and banned all worship as well. Not just close the churches, you're not allowed to visit and pray, not even allowed to worship in the church. So officially, it's gone back to Protestant times of banning Mass. Now, St. Margaret of Scotland, whose feast day is the 10th of June, the name Margaret means pearl. And there can be no more fitting name for a woman who reigned in Scotland from 1070 to 1093. Hers is a romantic story good for all Catholic examples. Now, she was deprived of her father at an earthly age. She and her mother were seeking shelter and protection when storms struck their ship to the shores of Scotland. The King Malcolm III was friendly to them and captivated by Princess Margaret, beautiful, virtuous, talented, and full of the Holy Catholic faith. The king then asked for her hand in marriage, which she accepted despite her wish to enter the convent. Now, their marriage was an ideal one. Margaret was cultured and religious, her husband was rough and uncouth. But under her influence, his temper softened, his manners became polished, and he developed into one of the most virtuous kings to sit on the throne in Scotland. His wife Margaret induced the king to perform works of justice and mercy, charity, and all the virtues. She led her husband, king, to join her in prayer, and together they encouraged the arts of civilization, education, the arts, and of course all the works of religion. And God blessed this royal couple with 8 children, 6 sons and 2 daughters, all of which grew up to be outstanding Catholics. The Queen not only took care of her own family, but all the servants, the whole household, and the entire kingdom. Her private life was very strict. She ate little and spent much time in prayer, evening shortening her sleep to say more prayers. She kept the 2 Lent strictly, the actual season of Lent and Septuagesima and Advent as well. And during those periods, she made the habit of rising at midnight, go to the church and pray. Every day at stated time she would pray and do spiritual reading, especially reading the stories of the Gospels. Realising how precious the prayers of his holy wife Margaret were, King Malcolm would rise to pray with her. He would kiss the holy books she used and occasionally take the books and cover them with jewels. Saint Margaret would weep over her slightest faults and over the many sins of the world, and they promoted every word charity and mercy. St. Margaret, of course, like every mother, had her crosses to carry. As she lay dying, word came to her that her husband and one of her sons had been killed in battle defending the kingdom. Yet she was able to exclaim, "O Lord Jesus Christ, who by thy breath you give life to the world, deliver me." And with these words, she breathed her last and headed for her heavenly home. So hers was a family modelled on the Holy Family of Nazareth. Their royal palace, of course, would have had all the temptations to pride, ease of living, neglect of religion, that might come to those in high places. Yet the home in many ways was like that of Jesus and Mary and Joseph in Nazareth. It was a house of prayer, love of God, love of neighbour at home, a place of contentment, and love of neighbour outside. Now, like the Holy House of Nazareth, the Royal Palace of Scotland was a house of prayer, regular daily prayer in which the entire family took part. In the Holy House of Nazareth, the growing Jesus talked to his Heavenly Father, while Mary and Joseph directed their minds to the Almighty, begging help in carrying out the high responsibility God had given to them. Prayer made the place palace of Scotland, like the Holy House of Nazareth. Love of God also made them alike. Love of the Lord and worship of Him, which always came first. The royal family proved their love of God. keeping his laws, imitating the virtues of the Holy Family, I promote everywhere that might turn to the honour and glory of worship of God. Love of neighbour at home. What deep affection would there be between the Holy Family, Jesus, Mary and Joseph? Joseph showed his love and affection by protecting his spouse Mary, being thoughtful and considerate, and by cooperating with her in all the work of the home. Mary and Jesus, of course, loved St. Joseph. They worked with him and for him to make him comfortable, to understand him and appreciate him. And so did Mary and Joseph love the Divine Son. How their hearts were filled with the joy and privilege of caring for the Son of God. In St. Margaret, her kindness, patience and example led her husband and children to the knowledge of and service of God, which all mothers should do. And of course, it was a place of contentment. Things people want at home, of course, is a place of contentment. How uncontented things are if there's someone difficult at home. But where there is mutual love and understanding, cooperation and self-sacrifice and unselfishness, wherever there is religion and interest in religion, there we find contentment. Perhaps the royal couple did not give pictures, but they did experience by their labour for the work of God, the truth of the words, Ecclesiasticus chapter 40. The life of the labourer who is content with what he has shall be sweet. And love of neighbour. Margaret and Malcolm promoted works of charity, fed the poor, and, as the story goes, even washed their feet. Visiting the sick, erecting homes for strangers and ransomed captives, and during that they would feed and serve 300 beggars with the same food they served themselves. So I want to go on with comparisons for the Holy Family and the one in Scotland under King Malcolm and Queen Margaret. The importance is that, like them, we must model our family home after that as the Holy House in Nazareth. Imitate them and the example of St. Margaret and her family, and the many other great Catholic families through history. And with their help and with their prayers, our homes will be modelled upon the Holy House of Nazareth, the Holy Family, and be a place of contentment and peace. In the name of the Father,
Jesus.
Per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Dominus vobiscum. Sergamus Domino Deo Nostro. Veri dignum et justum est, decum et salutare. Nos tibi semperibique gratia sagere. Dominus sanctipater omnipotens et ene Deus. Quia cum unigenitus tuus, in substantia nostra, mortalitatis apparuit, nova nos immortatis sue, luce reparabit, et ideo cum angelus ec archangelus, cum thonus ad dominatio nipus, cum quae omnimit milite celestis exercitus, Hymnum gloriae tuae canimus, sine fine decente.
Thank you, thank you.
Oh.
nobis quaeque peccatoribus. Per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Oremus bishop de solitaribus monarchi, et divina institutione formati, audemus dicere. Pater noster, qui es in celis, sanctificetur nomen tuum. Adveniat regnum tuum, via voluntas tua, sicut in cielo et in terra. Panem nostrum quotidianum da nobis hodie, et dimitte nobis debita nostra, sicut et nos dimittimus debitoribus nostris, et ne nos inducas in tentationem. Omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Pax Domini sit semper vobiscum.
Et nunc spiritu tuo.
Thank you.
Miserat vest omnipens de salus salat versus figure of God for the evil day. In evidencia maxis and lucian and calma strong with the sun pens physical stones. Ecce nostra ecce catola peccata mundi. Domine non sum nemus in this day of man and of the seven air and of man. Domine non sum nemus in this day of man and of the seven air and of man. Domine non sum nemus in this day of man.
Your church is perseverant, alleluia.
omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Dominus omnibus.
Et cum spiritu tuo.
Dominus initium sancti evangelii secundum meha. In principe verbum, verbum putem, et deus erect verbum, macet in principe putem. Omnipus factus sum, et sinesu factum est ne factum est. In itse videre, fidus lux omnum. Et lux intellis lucet, et in vain non comprenduit. Fiat omnis visite, cum in nomine ratio hae, si pen testimonium testimonium praet de lumen. Somnum cadam per lumen, non ever lux testimonium praet de lumen. Ere lux fere quae illuminat omnum hominum venenum uc mundum. In mundo durat, munus factus est, munus ei non cuc negit, in propter venitus sorum eum non recepere. Procurum recepere, and et ide est personam infidusti viri. Esque omni esque non ex inguinis nequis, voluntanis nequis, voluntata viri, sed ex te nati sunt. Et verbum cae factum est, et habita vidim verbis. Et vidim scoiae scoquae si ingenia patre. Panium gratiae et veritas. Thank you.